What you mean, brother?
Friend and neighbor to him, down there on that show. There's an offer for him. We've been doing this very much. I noticed in the mail we got a few requests for it. Jerry and Sid know you on me on this one. Sam, do you have any thoughts on what you've done? You, Don? Huh? G. Gathering flowers for the master bouquet. Help is an angel sent down from above. Thank for the buds of the flowers we love. Each soul is a flower in the master's bouquet. Gathering flowers for the master's bouquet. Beautiful flowers that will never decay.
Favorites, right? Oh, beautiful. The God who creates all things, who laughs with us and weeps with us, the God who walks with us every step of life's way. He carries us when our strength fails. He knows our hearts. He knows every heart's depth. One silent thought, every tear-stained eye, every outburst of emotion of loss, this God knows, and he loves you, family and friends. God loves you. He will move in and around us this morning as we prepare our hearts to say not goodbye, but until we meet again. For this is not a funeral, but a homegoing celebration for our blessed family member, Lorene Wheeler, for she has made it home. For she is nowhere that we cannot be, that we will be one day if we choose to be. For the Bible says in John 14, it begins out, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. John 14:6 says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. God has provided a way back to him. And we have to make the choice to follow that way. The ways of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. Romans 6:23, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. You see, Lorene didn't have to face death. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And that is where she's at right now. God had given her so many wonderful, wondrous gifts and talents. And I had two songs here, or poems that she wrote. And as I was reading the one, it kind of shook me to the core, because I have to minister in a church tonight. And this Leave It in Its Path is an actual outline to the message I had studied out. It says, God is phenomenal in the ways that he moves. But I want you to hear this. Lorene wrote this herself. It says, we are so eager to complain about our woes when sunlight leaves us and the rain so swiftly upon us flows. Now, me, myself, I'm prone to grumble to anyone who'll hear, especially when the thunder rumbles and pounds upon my ear. If we would only stop to think of those worse off than we, we'd be so glad that we can sing, praise him eternally. So my friends, if you feel blue and think you want to pout, just sing a song from heart so true and praise him with a shout. You see, it's true that in the end, all things work out for the good to those who are called to work for him, and we must surely should. So when you've tried and done your best to please your fellow man, but still can't seem to pass the test, just leave it in his hand, because God takes care of all things. What wisdom this shows that my cousin had when she wrote this, praise God. And the other one is called The Big Tree. Once there was a big tall tree, it reached up to the sky, and everyone who came to see it said, oh me, oh my. This tree sure stood out of all the rest. It was so plain to see that it was called the very best. It was no surprise to me. One day a man came passing by, and when he looked around, he said, this tree is much too high. We'll have to cut it down. The people came from far and near. They gathered all around. The children cried they could not bear to see it hit the ground. And then a stranger came and said, don't touch that tree, it's mine. I dug a hole and planted it when I was only 9. And so the tree still stands today, so straight, so tall, so proud. And I think I can safely say that it will always draw a crowd. This was written about her son, and he had planted a tree when he was only 9. Isn't that amazing? Praise God. I could write some poems about my children and my grandchildren, but they wouldn't be like this. And I'm just being trying to be a little lighthearted there, but I just want you all to know, as I thought on these things even last night, I kind of felt impressed that maybe Lorene was pushing me. And so I'm going to push you like she pushed at me. If you're here this morning and you don't know the Lord Jesus as your Savior, so you can look upon her again, then there's no time like the present. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. For greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Therefore I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. For the joy of the Lord is my strength. And that will come when you accept the Lord as your Savior. So I don't know where you all are at today. I don't know your hearts. I don't know your lives. But if you do not know Jesus as your personal Savior, if you have not asked him to be your Lord, then I humble you to do so today. And you can just close your eyes and bow your heads and just talk away to the Lord. Sometimes people think they have to have a church to go to and an altar to walk down to. But God is the altar. The throne of God is your altar. And you can get saved driving your car. You can get saved milking a cow like a farmer that I once knew. The Lord is always ready to answer and supply. And sometimes, like Lorene's poem says, we get so busy grumbling about what is life, what's in our life, and we forget, praise God, we have life, and we have it more abundantly. And so I would behoove you to accept the Lord as your Savior if you have not done so. There is a song that I feel like today, now Lorene knows the story behind this song. There is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. Oh, what a day, a glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see. And I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me to his promised land. What a day, a glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrows there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness, no pain, no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. Oh, what a day, a glorious day that will be. So as you look upon Lorene this morning, just remember, this is the shell that God granted her as she walked about on the earth. But she has gone on to what a day that will be. Her day had come. She had served her purpose and lived for the Lord the best she could, did the best she could. We all make mistakes in life. We all have our hard times and then our good times. But God is always patient to forgive and to raise us up to face another day. The sin is not so much in the fall, children, as it is in the refusal to rise again. And no matter how sick she got, how much pain she may have been, she rose every morning giving God the glory. And when you read the back of her obituary, you'll see all the things that she had done, things that I didn't even know. And I was just so blessed then, and it was an honor to be here this morning and to see all of you. And I just want you to be joyful in heart, as sad as the moment is, that Lorene is with her Heavenly Father. She has reached her eternal home. And we thank the Lord for that this morning. And that's the end of the service for today. She's got one more song she's going to play.
I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. He's the lily of the valley. In him all I see. All I need to cleanse and make me fully whole. In sorrow he's my comfort. He's my stay. He tells me every care on him grow. He's the lily of the valley, the bright morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. Oh, shall fear.
and sweeping out glory to see his blessed face, where the river of delight shall ever roam. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 2,000 to my soul. He's the fairest of 2,000 to my soul.
Yeah, we'll come on feet first, that way we don't want to switch it around.
Plenty of room in the shade, so come on up.
Oh, you know what? We gotta wait for her.
I can feel his spirit.
We'll wait for us while the ladies sit down.
Okay, grandma.
Sit down, baby.
Heavenly Father, we thank you. Lord, we praise you and we thank you that we know where Lorene is, Father, and that she is in the peace of your holy presence, a day that we all long to be, Jesus. We thank you for her life and for every life that she's touched. And Lord, we just pray that you will bless this family and keep them, Lord. Give them peace, Heavenly Father. We thank you for each one that came out today, dear God. And we know that all those that are here because you had ordained it to be so. And we just want to magnify your mighty name and thank you for all that you've said and done, Lord, and for all the comfort that you've given the family, Jesus. And help them to know each time that they feel to shed a tear that you'll wrap your arms around them, Lord. We give you all the praise and all the glory as we've come to honor the life of our precious cousin, Lord. mother, grandmother, great-grandmother. We just praise and thank you. A sister, Lord, she's had her life filled with so much, Lord. And we just thank you for that today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
There's a blessing that the Lord, that is often spoken, and I wrote it down because I wanted to make sure I didn't leave anything out. But I want you to leave with this blessing on your hearts. It says, may the good Lord bless you and watch over you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look kindly upon you and give you peace. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
On behalf of the girls, I first want to thank Yolanda for her godly tribute today and the pallbearers and everyone that came to the visitation last night and the funeral today. I do want to ask that you guys keep sharing memories to these two ladies up front. They will want to hear those. This does conclude our graveside service.
She might be.
I'll take one.
Would anybody else like a flower?